they typically are offensively last year, 11th in the Big Ten in scoring in conference games, but overhauling the offense this year. And so let's start there. Dave Ripson, Jerry DiNardo, and Howard Griffith, as we go through some of the personnel and what we saw from this Nebraska team. And I think we have to start at quarterback, guys, with Tanner Lee. From where I was standing, awfully impressed with the way he throws the ball and how he could fit into this scheme that we had become familiar with Mike Riley, but hadn't really seen as much these first couple of years.
Right, every offense is built around a quarterback, right? So Tanner Lee is just a terrific pro-formation quarterback, so the team's going to be built around him. Skill on the flanks, skill in the backfield. Maybe we don't know who exactly, but certainly enough there. The only thing I didn't get a great feel about is the offensive line. There was no scrimmage, which you wouldn't expect today. There was no inside drill, which I was hoping to see. But a lot of team periods, and it looks like they're positioned to have a good offensive line. But that would be the only question I'd come away from today's practice. I love the scheme. I love the coaches. I think this scheme gives them the best chance to win a championship.
A veteran offensive line. You got a lot of starts in that offensive line, so that's really going to help the development of that passing game. I think it's important. I think you're right on. When you talk about Tanner Lee being that pocket passer that's going to be able to make good decisions, got to increase the completions, though. You know, that was a little low, probably around 56% before, but I think he'll be able to do that. Taking that year off, being on the scout team, you know, kind of allows you to study the game. Even though it's a new system, it still gives him an opportunity each and every day in practice to work on his skill set. Even though it's new, I think he's going to be terrific for this offense.
And as well as you can throw the ball, you know, Mike Riley made it very clear. You know, studying the Big Ten Conference the last couple of years, of last year he made the point the teams that had the most success are the ones that run the ball the best and turn it over the least. And so that's where he wants to go. And he even said, we don't want to get enamored with the pass game. Yeah. Even though you might have a big arm at quarterback, that's not necessarily the way to win this league.
And keep in mind, they were enamored with the pass game at his previous stop. I mean, they were going to throw it every down if they wanted to.
Right
now, all of a sudden, right, they've got a run game that's really going to help complement the passing game that they have.
And I think it's also different in the Pac-12 than it is in the Big Ten. I mean, different league, teams win in different ways. It tends to be a little bit
weather,
more of an open offense.
Yeah.
The weather makes it easier to focus on a passing game, although I'm not sure necessarily in Corvallis. But but I agree with your point there. But they do look really good backs, right? I mean, you lose Terrell Newby, who was a big part of what you do, but to have Wilbon and Ozigbo, and I like Trey Bryant, both times that we've seen him, I think it's a really good group.
Yeah, and to go back to our original conversation about the reboot, they were never going to be a spread team, right? I mean, they were only a spread team because Tommy Armstrong was here, and he was their best quarterback.
And give them credit for that, too,
absolutely.
Not trying to do square peg in a round hole, for saying, here's what we have, here's what gives us the best chance to win. And they won 9 games last year.
They gave him the best chance to win short term. I don't think he gave him the best chance to win the West and win the Big Ten.
Right.
Now, this scheme, whatever shortcomings it has personnel, if it has any, they'll recruit to it. But this is the scheme that gives Nebraska the best chance to win.
The big headline here in the offseason, we've already talked about it some, was Bob Iacco coming as the defensive coordinator. So let's flip to that side of the ball. It is, again, a very different look, right? The 3-4 defense guys, the odd man fronts that we've been talking about. So right there, schematically, it's different. Let's run through that a little bit, how it's going to manifest itself, and then what you thought of personnel.
Well, I think when you start to look at that scheme, the 3-4, you immediately think pressure. Pressure on the offensive line, the backs, the tight ends, and also the quarterback to understand where those blitzes are trying to come from. I do like the personnel. Is it perfect for what they want to do long term? Probably not. They probably will start to recruit some different players. But the linebacking group as a whole can run. They're thick, they're physical, they want to get downhill. So that's going to be an advantage for them. So they're going to have some opportunities where they're going to be lined up against the back in pass rush, and they're going to win a lot of those battles because they're so physical.
Bob Diaco is an entirely different style coach than they've had in the past on defense with Mark Banker. They're energized. So I think, and I agree with you, that this is the best practice we've seen since we've been coming to Nebraska, regardless of who's coached here. And I think a lot of it is both sides of the ball staff are energized.
It was interesting. I talked to Mike Riley at the very outset of practice, and I was asking him about Bob Diaco. And, you know, I expected it to be a lot of schematic answers that, you know, this gives us the best chance, or we think this can get people off balance. It's a defense you don't see as much. But the first thing he talked about, and the thing he talked about the most, was the energy in the room, connecting with the players, all of that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
He said he just felt like it had brought an entirely different feel to his team. And then we got into the X and O stuff, which I know for football people who like to go on the Grease Report, really interesting stuff. But that really resonated with me, the fact that he said how much these players have responded to Bob Iacco personally. Yeah. So when you have both aspects of that, probably onto something. Lots more to come from Lincoln, but for now.